you yesterday on a little tour of my honeymoon place.
Yeah, that's Bergen in Norway, where the country was given up in wartime to the Nazis.
Yeah, and I've explained to you in the last couple of days all of the links of the world elites and the world leaders to the same family bloodline as the people that wrote the Christian Bible. And there's the joke about the Bank of International Settlements, the David Thimbleby family that are at the war memorial every Remembrance Sunday, and that is the joke about Belson Bergen, that is the execution of all of the wives and children of the warriors in the wars that get killed by people like her and people like him, and they are related to people like her. Yeah, who continues in the crime scene with Helen Clark in New Zealand, giving up everything that those countries could have if the people that are so besotted with sport and ice hockey and issues like that could actually focus on what their politicians were doing to them. That is the bee gods all around Celine Dion, who's related to him and to her, and not to him because he's just a plant in the genocidal team so that the news can be presented, and that the royals, who are not in that story just yet, yeah, can be in charge of the poppy fund. Every great conflict. Okay? So, that's the song that I just played, that I selected to dance with my disloyal wife at my wedding. Yeah? Before we went to Bergen in Norway, on the P&O Empire ships that Michael Moore and him defraud the whole world with, 82 companies, that's Michael Moore, Secretary of State for Scotland, used to run. And I explained to you how the gods have been completely written out of the story, and you can see the sly grin on all of their faces because they understand that, and that's the lumberjacks in the Bank of England and the Bank of International Settlements. And I thought somewhere we had the bank of, that's the Nazi loot bank in Switzerland, and that is now the joke about the business, innovation and skills, the Bank of International Settlements. And that is the Dalek joke for the Jesus fraud, because of the time shift that Calpurnius Piso needed to change the writing of the Bible about Jesus, and the Camilla ships of the desert things. And that is the goddess joke, yeah, about dancing with death in every one of the great conflicts. Okay, so let's lighten up. Okay, that is the dead at Belson, that is the eugenicists preparing them for the deaths at Belson. Okay, and I've forgotten to prepare or pre-prepare the song about, yeah, if you go down to the woods today, you notice they're in the wood, yeah? Everything is the same shrubbery joke. You are the bravest of hearts and you are the strongest of souls. Okay? That's what happens to every one of the innocents in every one of the conflicts that they engineer. Yeah, and they think it's really, really funny. Yeah, all of those women are Canadians. She's a Canadian, she's a Frenchie first, okay, like loads of them in Quebec, and that is the Lancelot du Lac joke. Okay, do you get it? That's the Quebec region where I won a prize for writing a story about the cliffs there and the huge conflicts between the Redcoat armies from Britain. That's General Wolfe. Right then, so let's get on with the story. And the prostitute that I showed you in this one is not anything to do with my wife or Hemel Hempstead. It is, in fact, this woman. Yeah, she's Joan Collins. That's Joan, the French person who is the heroic icon for women sacrificing their lives, yeah, for the love of their nation. And she becomes a saint in the Christian church. This one's not been sainted yet, but nothing would surprise me. Yet all of those funds that the Rockefellers deploy. So let's first look at the tabs, because I've got a lot to tell you today. So I've just started on the Onassises this morning. Not enough time to reveal any of that, but in the local papers yesterday, on the issue of the man who's being convicted, who sings about the pie in America, hey, Mr. American Pie, yeah, I forget what the name of the man is. The person who's pictured on the front page of the Scottish papers is a man called Totsy Watson. And that is the Totsy website joke, and that is the Watson joke about the links to the families that are the DuPont families. That's the mafias that got the gods all riled up. And Totsy Watson has repeatedly said to me that his story and his nickname being called Totsy and his surname being Watson is nothing to do with the Totsy website, which it used to expose the religious scam that the Pisos defrauded the whole world with. Yeah? Now what you get on that Totsy website is the tits out for all, and it's quite explicit. You've got movies of people fornicating three lovers at the same time. Yeah? And that means that no one can look at the angel fire evidence for all of the stuff that's on the Totsy website. That religion is just a total fake, okay? And in some of these things, when we click on them, we may be lucky enough, they have now totally removed Dad's Army from YouTube, okay? They're replacing the Dad's Army cast with a new version of Dad's Army, because I revealed that the Calpurnius Piso word is emblazoned on the shoulders of every one of those Dad's Army uniforms. So they've made a new version, and the man who plays Albrecht, yeah, in the things that I've told you about the Otterburn Hunt, he's in the cast. Okay, right then. So what are the tabs today? We're on to the 13 mafia families again. It's quite placid outside, so the gods are reasonably content that the story's coming out. And this is not nearly as vicious as the stuff that we've told you about the DuPonts and the calamitous events for ecology on our globe. Remember that the Jesus joke is the global warming joke, because the icon for El Nino is the baby Jesus dolly. Yeah, traded all around the world, and that now becomes the joke that Bill Clinton and every one of the green families, yeah, that are profiteering from our every breath now. Yeah, that's the tax on breathing that was resolved at the Paris summit, and all of the Paris shenanigans feature all of this all through human history. That's Joan Collins, the bitch. But the Collinses are one of the 13 mafia families. You better watch out, she's still alive. She was on the centrefold for Playboy way right into her late 40s and early 50s. Yeah, and the women that play the same role in this ruthless family get murdered, and nobody cares about that, because that's what these families do. Okay, let's sex it up a bit. Right then. So, they're in charge of all sorts of financial operations, these people. Okay, I'll go through the Collins tab, because most of the pictures I've got on there this time, the subtitles there are financial services, and this is a company check for the DRUID Council. Yeah, Collinses run the DRUID Council. Okay, this one's registered in Hemel, where they used to have the sex shop. But since I started to tell my stories, all of those things have had to be closed, and it helps with the reputation of Butlins too. Okay, that's Druid Limited, 68 at Mount Drive, London, and one of those registrations is in Hemel. Okay, where the sex shop used to be. Right then, So global corporations, I can now search for companies all around the world. And it's ever so insightful. Okay, here's the Druid companies. That one's in Florida. Inactive, non-profit, 102, this is the Collinses run the Druid circles. Yeah, and they run the global corporations for the Druids. Okay, and that is the pagans. Yeah, the whole of the religious world, they have to capture your mind and keep the control of it, which is why the Rockefellers fund the psychology of religion. Okay, right into where the Pilgrim Fathers went to first. Okay, so we'll get a little bit of time to name names on those directorates and see how many of them still run. Yeah, that's tiny compared to the other stats that we've got. Okay, can you guess what else the Collinses were involved in? Okay, so that is the Rand companies, that's the South African currency. Yeah, and I've told you all about the takeover by the Round Table, run by the people that are in charge of all of that stuff, which is where we finished off yesterday as I talked to you about Prince Philip's Alamein SS. Okay, so there's the Rand corporations and all the Canadian jokes. Yeah, that's Canada Inc. with the name Rand in it. Yeah, and that is the joke about South Africa and the issues about the genocides in South Africa that were the only way that the British authorities, yeah, they're all over Canada now, they own it. That's the joke about Prince Philip being in Canada the day that he demonised Putin, when Putin was hosting the World Economic Forum in St. Petersburg. Yeah. He claimed that Putin was the most evil man on the earth since Hitler. Yeah, and Hitler is a Rothschild, and all of the Rothschilds sire his bloodline, Prince Charles, the liar and the thief at the world's expense. Okay, another one. Sadly, I believe that the goddess that I loved when I was a child, and she rides around on the horses, she now lives in Winchester, where my first boss, Dr. Jones, retired to, is, her name is Judy Bowker, and sadly they sing the song about Venus, which is also, yeah, one of the gods' jokes, and it is also the song about the Venus characters in the stories about religion are quite evil. So Judy is just one letter away from the Bower directors that are also part of the Collins Mafias. Okay, not sure what, we got loads of hits for them. Okay, 1750 results for them. Okay, limited liability for all of them. Okay, and they're all over the world. Flinders Park, South Africa, Bedfordshire, United Kingdom, and Maidstone, Kent. Okay, Bower Mount Road, and there's 10,000 directors. Okay, I'm pining for that love supreme. Yeah, and all of the Shania Twain links to all of those scams in Las Vegas. She's now on her second husband. The Matt husband is a joke about some of the characters in the Hanna-Barbera cast. That's the Muttley jokes. Yeah. And she's now confined to Las Vegas. Yeah, she's out of New Zealand now. Don't know how often she spends her time down there. And I hate to think about that Helen Clark woman and what she has done to that country. Okay, that's Shania's partner in New Zealand. Okay, talking about partners, here's a really sexy bit. This is Bill Clinton's parentage again. Okay, that's Hillary's husband. Yeah, that is the parent of Bill Clinton, the Harriman woman. Okay, Pamela Digby Churchill, nay Harriman. Okay, and some of the directorates we've got. I've got one of my enemies in life. When I was writing to the MP for Newcastle, where Miliband's brother was an MP, and he fled the day I put the guillotine on my website, yeah, I was talking to a lovely woman who never ever replied, but she's a socialist from Newcastle, and we got into a little tiff about her allegiance with the Churchill family, and a guy called Garry Churchill declared that he was going to have my head off before the weekend. And I've got his director numbers now, and he is on the Tavistock Institute Mental Health Boards, and he monitors and profiteers from all of the mental health, mind control, manipulation that is the Tavistock registrations that I have further down the list. Okay? So, I got it wrong. That is, the woman who was Randy Churchill, I believe, is the parent of Churchill himself. Yeah, and this one is the American ambassador, yeah, and she is the real parent of Bill Clinton. But her child that they declare for the world is also called Winston Churchill. So if you've got two of them, the whole of the world gets confused by that. But the other Winston Churchill is also a politician in Westminster. I only discovered that bit last night. She's a dead ringer for my new friend who is in Intel. Yeah? And is a friend of Charles Sanderson of Bowden. And the Melrose School. Yeah, it scares me shitless. The whole world is run by Freemasons and all of them are jokers. That's Bill Clinton's mum. And the Harrimans are really legendary. I forget where she was ambassador to. Let's have a wee look at that. Oh, guess where she's ambassador to? Where Hillary's genes come from. Yeah, okay. 58th United States ambassador to France, where everybody's in the silk stockings because they are still just those madams that we told you about in the Hollande story. Okay, and the Albrights, really sinister, they come across to America on the SS America. Yeah, and she becomes, yeah, one of the foreign secretary for Bill Clinton, the son of that woman in the Rothschild yellow jacket. Thank you to my new friend. She's lovely. And she came and had coffee with me, and I get to kiss her both times I've met her in the flesh. Yeah, she used to be Intel, and I believe that she came forward when I started to talk about it, but she does not show any signs of fear. She's a very courageous woman, and I will continue to court her favour. Not to the extent that Churchill's ancestors did, okay? And I will never, ever expose her to that beheading threat that Garry Churchill turned on me when I hit on the socialists from Newcastle. Okay, so Winston Churchill, the politician, let's have a little look at him and what he looks like. Yeah, looks a bit like my relatives in Jeddah, a little bit. He's got a very taut looking, anxious looking grin. So this is the official cover for the birth of Bill Clinton. Okay, he's in the Houses of fucking Parliament. Yeah, and he died in 2010. Okay, and that is not 66 years this time. Okay, so, and this one is looks really, really sinister. She's a Foreign Office official in America. Yeah, look at her fazog. Everybody loves somebody sometime. And I picked that, yeah, and I had to dance. Yeah, I don't like dancing because it's kind of demeaning. And it's like the ritual dances that everybody dances to before they go to their deaths in the troops. Yeah, I prefer to think about what everybody else is doing, which is why I did not have a stag night. I've told you, I think, the stories about my wife's stag night and the chattels that I still have from that. Yet that's the dildos and things, and everything is trivialised. This one has got Taze Russell's icon on her shoulder. Yeah, she's a Christian too, out of Czechoslovakia, where they had the massive storms, and that's where Robert Maxwell and the other people went to. She's a socialist in America, really lucky to survive with her life. Yeah, quite spooky when you read down and you see the ships are taking all of these double agents all the way across the Atlantic. And the ship, for a laugh, that's why I captured that, it got grounded on the beach, yet it's no longer in commission. Yeah, the Tavistock thing is vicious. This is the mind control centre where Hitler was trained, where Stalin was trained, and all of the warmongers were trained to kill and to steal all of those continents like Churchill did. He's the one of the biggest killers in the world. Yeah, and that's the story I told you about young Winston being the war correspondent for South Africa in the Boer War, when they killed all of the women and children as the only way they could win that war. Right then, so there's a picture of the SS America. Hopefully it's the one where it shows you on the beach, because all of the acts of God are massive. Okay, I think at the bottom we'll see it grounded. Yeah, maybe not, but it's getting built. Yeah, under construction, and all of the profiteering from that, it's sponsored by Eleanor Roosevelt. Isn't that a lovely thing for the presidents to do when they sailed there on the mill, on the Fortune? Yeah, that's Franklin D. Roosevelt with his estate called Springwood, and also with the Murrays of Fala in his bloodline. Remember that Hilary Clinton has the Della Murray. Yeah, I don't know where she came from in Scotland or in Britain. Yeah, but we've got a good idea of all of the epicentres for them now. Okay, so let's see. And this, I was quite stunned by this, because the ships were designed by Eggers and Higgins. Yeah, that is Egger, where my wife worked, and that is Egger, where all of the scandals of all of those Ponzi schemes are, and that is the people that do the work surfaces and the linoleum and the condominiums, and all of that is the Jesus Piso joke. Okay, right then. And there's Stiegler and Stiegler with the 31 other German agents of the De Quesne spy ring. All of the intel is launched all over the world, tier after tier after tier of it, so everybody has to live in suspicion of their neighbours. And my neighbour Colin came to me yesterday and said, you deserve to be banged up, yeah, because I'm investigating the Collins families. Yeah, he worships at the Catholic Church, his wife worships at the Episcopalian Church, both of the sad bastards, yet we're on the course where they're preparing for elected office, and he's the one that runs the hotel syndicate and was going to invite me to speak in front of the Pope. Yeah, and when you dob on them and when you expose them, they shrink away. I would love to meet Colin in open-handed combat. He walks with his hands joined together down the church aisle, yeah, as if he is going to be sainted himself someday. And all of it is entirely for profit. And he's the one that runs the hotel chain. That's the Queen's Head Hotel. And his links are to those hotel chains that take in the Von Trips, the SS people in the Formula One sector. That's the Von Tripp family singers, for a laugh, in Formula One. Right then, and this is even more sinister than the religions, because this is about mind control and creating people with no thought processes and making them into robotic characters. Yeah, all of that happens, and all of that mind control system, I was immune from that, They tried to hypnotise me, yeah, but they could not hypnotise me, okay? Okay, so this is the Tavistock Institute for Human Relationships, all officers, and there's the Brana actor, yeah, that is in all of those comedies about Shakespeare, yeah? May not be him, but it will be his bloodline, okay? So, and it, I've got other directorates for the medical psychology department, and that is the psychiatry thing that Garry Churchill is a part of. Neil Gareth Churchill, director, 19th September 2014, just after he had his tiff with me. Yeah, I forget the name of the lovely lady from Newcastle who never responded to the socialist. Yeah, like the Milibands, all of them have fucked off now. Yeah, because all of them, we've got their profiteering director numbers for. Okay? I think as they still have got that sectioning threat close to me, I will read out some of those names now. Agnes Bryan, Gordon Robert Lane, directors, officers. Okay? Hazel Catherine Wright, King's. This is the World Control Centre for Mind Control at Tavistock. Martin Beresford Ruddy, Neil Gareth Churchill, Nicholas Pierce, the Piso joke, Peter Bruce Moleverer, Robert Graham Jezzard, Robert Roland Smith, Rosamond Mary Breyer, Stan Ruzinski, formerly inactive directors now, Alexis Brook, Annie Pleshett Murphy, Anton Meinhard Obholzer, Anton Meinhard Obholzer, Beatrice Nancy Sear, like the Sears that I know who are the friends of the Greys in Edinburgh, used to play rugby there, right next to Murrayfield, Carola Gwyn Thorpe, and some of the stories on this listing for the Collins take you into the Todds again, really spooky. Yeah, my mate G. Todd had a series of really serious kidney stones quite recently. He's the one that told me about the death of the people on the chutes. Yeah? And his brother died really young in a car accident many, many years ago. There's the Kemp linkages, Donald William Kemp Berg. And the Hitchcocks, I think, are... Oh, and there's a George Crichton Hume. Yeah, you know, the pacifists of the borders that make those radio interviews. Like MSP John Lamont now makes interviews with 8-year-old kids. Eric Miller, grinding the bones. Okay, Heather Vivian Stevens, Helen Ruth Martin, Ian Sinclair, Jane Helen Violet Lloyd, June Huntingdon, Linda Chung, Margaret Ann Yellowley, Margaret Elizabeth Rustin, Marilyn Jane Miller Petroni, and yesterday I saw some of those people that are from the Nenthorne place where I went to my first school. Yeah, and they come and talk to me all of the time when they know they're going to be in. There's a Victor Grey Hood. Yeah, that's the Hoods of legend, and also the heads of the Road Trust still. Okay, and there's a Coleman, like the excitable commentator who's in the DuPont lineage. Right then. Okay, and Garry Churchill, just to show you that I've got all his director numbers and all the profiteering things, Airways Extra Limited, Prisoners Advice Service, he's a psychologist in the mind control sector. Neil, yeah, the name of the Nile means Piso. Arthur Hastie, Gareth Churchill, okay? Neil Gareth Churchill, non-profit, the Respiratory Alliance Limited. Yeah, United Kingdom. Neil Gareth Churchill, Crisis UK. Neil Gareth Churchill, Director, Asthma Enterprises Limited, profiteering from healthcare, like many of them do. Neil Gareth Churchill, Director, Asthma UK Trading Limited, yet done, now whether or not Trevor Jones is a friend of his, Neil Gareth Churchill, Est Manco, Montague Road, that's the Dukes of Buccleuch Limited, okay? So, little bit of a hit back on Garry and his activities since we fell out on socialism in Newcastle. Yeah, and his threats, his death threats to me. I've got it all backed up on the computer next door, just in case I end up dead at any point. And when they kill, the Churchills are gifted Blenheim for their services to the grateful genocidal nations that are all around the world, run by the elites like Hillary and Donald and Bill, and all of them are in the same bloodlines, and they're really blood-sucking creatures. Right then, let's get back to the prostitutes. Yeah, okay. Everybody loves somebody sometime. I'm glad that waltz is over. Cynthia Payne, personal services cover. Okay? And that's the Madeleine Albright story. And that is Pamela Harmon was Bill Clinton's mother on YouTube. Yeah, that's Greg Hallett's work, now dead at the hands of HRH and the police, with the word piezo in it. Oh, she's lovely. Yeah? Pamela Beryl Harriman, née Digby, 20th March 1920 to 1997. Okay. Skull and Bones, that's the warmongering. And the Whitneys are in their story as well. Dozens of covers for the Whitneys, like we have for the Eccleston word. Okay, and the DeWitts and all the owl stories, and that is mammy that I met in the supermarket yesterday, and the stories about having children as bastard children and getting them raised by other parents. Yeah, this man is a striking lookalike for one of my neighbours, lives right next door to my dad and lives right next door to Tootsie Watson. Yeah, and that is the American Pie song that everybody loved when I was a teenager. Yet he's been jailed because I'm exposing the pie secrets of the Piezo family. And Tootsie Watson, the website that exposes the whole of that religious fraud, is the person pictured on the front page. And I saw his sister, Christine, yesterday looking quite angry as she drove past my window in the car. Okay? And that's the Watsons that are affiliated to the DuPont that got the gods ever so angry. And this lot are affiliated to Putnam. And that man is the lookalike for Putnam, who was the boss at my university and is a massive warmonger and a joker about running for your country on a Sunday, and makes that joke in front of the whole world at the London Olympics, when my wife is soaking it up. And she understands the whole of it. Yeah, all of the jokes she understands because she trained in Intel at Baker Street with the SOE. And I saw a van that has replaced BT the other day. And it's a company, I forget what the name of it was, but all across the number plate, you have the SOE word. Yeah, and it's all, and when I talk to them, they're from Poland. Okay? So, and that's the energy company and the BT company that I make all of these videos from. Okay? And it's just amazing. Let's get to the top and show you the prostitutes. And they murder them, yet they murder them in a systematic way. And we've got the moonshots, yet also a Collins on board with the Armstrongs, the great Scottish revolutionaries. There she is. Okay. Everybody loves somebody sometime. Tits out all over the place. Okay. Now let's get quickly through it. Joan Collins is what I call a soft connection. She has association with a long list of key Illuminati men and at least a few known Satanists, but this is only the barest of Jews that she might have anything to do with the Illuminati herself. Let me give some of the hard connections first. Let's look down till we get to pictures, okay? This is the meeting that is held twice yearly and to which the Rothschilds and all the mother families attend. Yeah, that's the Rothschilds, who are not on any of the rich lists. The meeting is inside in a big room, and the grandmother on the throne was a Collins. The Collins family has been kept out of the limelight because they have more occult power than the Rothschilds or the Rockefellers. To make money, this Collins family does something financially, such as a deal with the exchange of money. The grandmother Collins, dressed in black, has an ebony and gold moon-shaped throne that she can sit. She can automatically rotate by pushing a pedal with her foot. Something similar for HRH when they lived in Brighton. Yeah, that's Queen Victoria's people. Yeah, I remember the stories about the chairs and all of the pot shit analysis stuff for the doctors. Okay, behind her sits the Grand Council. That's the Druid Council. Okay, and this is 1955. It's still going on, I believe. And that is the Eyes Wide Shut movie and all of the stories about Commoner Kate and the prostitution that gets her the kingdom. Okay, 7 children in white were brought in from generational satanic families and presented before Grandmother Collins. They laid prostrate in worship. She would move her scepter with a snake up and down, striking the floor. That's the doctor's Hippocratic Oath. To show approval of a child candidate, then 7 other children were sacrificed for the 7 approved children, 1 for each child, whose name would then be written with a quill using the sacrificed child's blood. Yeah, I don't go for that stuff. It may be true. You can believe it if you like. That's what we get in the papers now. None of the financial crimes are now anywhere exposed because all of the world leaders are doing them. And we're blaming the global warming on what you do in inhaling all of that oxygen that belongs entirely to them. None of it belongs to the gods. Okay? So, the John the Baptist of the Antichrist put in an appearance, but none of these people pretend that they don't understand the piezo fraud. Yet it's all to scare the shit out of you about the devil. I don't believe there will be a devil. There may be a devil. If it is, it's highly likely to be Arius Calpurnius Piso, since he passed on. Yet he's the cleverest criminal that the world has ever known. Okay? And this is the stories about looking for the Antichrist, and that is the story about the Omen movie. Yeah? And they understand the laugh about false religion and the priest getting the lightning conductor through the heart. That's God's response to the corrupted priesthood. I don't believe at the bottom of the priesthood that there will be so much corruption. But when you get to the papacy, all of those choices are for genocide and diasporas and getting the Nazis where they need to be, so that the whole world can have the same story told every 60 to 70 years. Benjamin Cream, yeah, here's the creme de la creme joke again, born in 1924 and was deeply into the occult, and that's the Tara, vast tracts of land, American Revolution joke about emancipating the slaves again. Okay, and let's get down to the pictures because it's really, really sick. Okay, Creams Christ the Reader is directed to read the article on the Sufis in this newsletter. Referring back to the gold bricks laid before the grandmother's throne, there are several reasons that real gold is important to the Illuminati. Can you imagine what they are with the South African stories ringing in your ears? Okay? And one that could have been included is Robert Moore Collins, 1867, who was a member of the Pilgrims. With the word pie in it, and that is the Pilgrim Fathers. And the other song that I chose on my wedding day was Hobgoblin Nor Foul Fiend Shall Daunt His Spirit, He Who at the end will expose all of this as the biggest fraud that was ever perpetrated on what could be an innocent and prosperous world without any need for any armies to be deployed anywhere. Okay? An editor in the Washington and New York offices of the Associated Press. Yeah, that's the other thing that they need to have by the nuts. Okay? Chief newsman for Reuters, Illuminati-controlled press, and Eamon is limping terribly badly. That's Eamon from Reuters, from Peebles, where the Tweedsmuirs came and manipulated all of World War II, yeah, and all of the Doctor Who stories. Yeah, and he fishes on the local river. The Teviot, yeah, with the Christian cross at the front and Eve close behind. Okay, Bournemouth, England, he never married. Okay, this is the Rosicrucians, the Golden Dawns, and all the scare stories. All of them are Masons. That is really scary. James F. Collins, his position was presenter. When the Canadians set up a Societas Rosicruciana High Council, yeah, that's the Canadians that all of those women are in. Daniel Collins, eight degree Mason, had several positions on the council. The highest degree is the ninth degree, and this is the Grand DRUID Council. Could not find any financial details for them in Britain, yet still hundreds all across the world. Okay? Okay? Yeah. And so, in the spring of 1978, each of these people are powerful witches and have a great deal of power in the world. So do you get it? The witches are working to manipulate things for financial gain. The papacy is manipulating things for financial gain. The Episcopalian Church and the Church of England, yeah, where the Queen is the head of the representatives, all of them are on the take, and all of the war dead are profiteering tools. Yvonne Collins was on the Grand DRUID Council. Remember that the leading Satanists feel they have special blood. The top ones feel they are gods, okay? That's why Celine sings with the Bee Gees. The occult demonic power would not be strong enough for a convert to witchcraft. Yvonne's occult name is Legina. Yeah, and that's the John Legend songs. Yeah, but all of the beautiful love stories that I've been playing, and all of it begins to come out as soon as I begin to read about the families that are much less powerful than the Rothschilds. They're skillful in the occult and in the magic. And my wife from Hemel, where the sex shop has closed, still does the tarot cards. Okay, even mainline Christian ministers are expected to follow directives of the Grand DRUID Council, which is said to operate under the orders of the Rothschilds. Everyone who was high up in the Illuminati and are now Christians, remember Tom Collins. Collins, this is the Doubting Thomas story, right through since the Egyptian thing, where that was the coat of many colours for Joseph. Yeah? Yeah, and that is the, yeah, all of it keeps getting replayed at Bethlehem, and then you get the launch of Islam, and every one of it is for sectarian division and warfare. Collins was in the Illuminati, but for some reason the Lord changed his heart, and he began to talk to churches about what is really going on. No one talks about the Pisos but me. But now there's a new website out of Australasia. Since I began to demonise Otago University and the professoriate with all those Nazis in it, called Kirk Krause, yeah, that were involved in the mental sectioning, yeah, and chasing me out of that institution. He warned that what was going on, he was gunned down in a grocery store parking lot, and has been used as an example by the Illuminati to anyone else who dares utter a word. Have you seen my face in this video? Okay? Remember Tom Collins, they warned people in the covens, and now I've got the nomenclature for why Coventry is in the Queen's speech. The Windsors are experts in the occult sector too. This reminds me of another incident which happened to a brother in Olympia, Washington, the capital of Washington. 2 weeks after Reagan was elected, a beautiful Mercedes, that's Hitler's fleet, yeah, and the drug running families that I've talked about, pulled up to where this Christian brother was working. The guy who got out was obviously rich. His suit had to be in the neighbourhood of $800, and his wife had fox furs all around her neck. They said their son was going to work for the state. They wanted to look for a home for him. The woman was being independent and said, "I don't want to see the houses. I want to talk to this nice man." The houses were done by Donoghue Construction. The men went on to look at the houses, and the woman remained behind and talked. This Christian is an easy talker with people. He struck up a conversation naturally. He said, "I think it's great Ronald Reagan got elected. He's going to be a good president." The woman replied, "We wanted George Bush to get it." "Who's we?" the Christian asked to this rich lady, who kept tossing her furs back and forth. And she then replied, "The Illuminati." She said, "We're the enlightened ones, and George Bush was trained by us." Yeah, that is George Buisson from France, the French connection. Every one of those Freemasonic presidents, and that is George Bush and his dad, George Herbert Poppy Bush, the joke about the war dead, who were the head of the CIA and got Murdoch all of his jobs in leading the press that is now Fox News and News Corp and all of the stuff that has replaced Reuters. Okay, they've got tier after tier of false media now. You will not, and those are all of the people that spend all of their lives making up stories to cover the horrible truth about what's happened to our democratic funding. We could have it back in a fortnight if Tom Weatherston, Alec Nicol, and even the man from the Yorkshire Freemasons who lives in Yetham, yeah, like the Sheriff Peter Patterson. Yeah, the whole lot of them are a cabal of Masons on the take from the world's people, and every now and again they engineer a conflict to kill all of their people, that is their electorate. You will not walk into these people's houses and find incriminating books or objects. Remember Ted Bundy in the last issues? Yeah? Article. Ted was exactly the model of how many top Illuminati are. They are capable of the most horrendous things, but to everyone who know them, they are the most likeable, intelligent, normal people, Colin, from the churches, with that pious way that you walk down the aisle. Yeah, and you go to the political meetings and you train how to prepare for elected office, and then you tell me a crock of shit that you're going to get me talking to the Pope. And then when I hit on all of your neighbours for attempting to get me silenced, yeah, that's the people from Poland and the dentists, yeah, and all of the charitable scams that you engage in, I'm going to come back at you. And you don't need to be afraid of me because I'm a pacifist, but you should be more God-fearing in what you do, yeah, in your religious beliefs and your manipulation of everybody else's minds. People who knew, let's get on to some of the pictures, it's going to take me ages. Our Christian God reigns. Yeah, that's the God that never gets a mention. They also control the CIA and the FBI, I've just told you that. Okay, so be wise as serpents. Let's get rid of, I'm going to put this down for a few minutes so you can see how beautiful my body corporate is. Yeah, and I'm going to get rid of those little tabs in the corner that mean that we cannot see the comments I've placed on it. Okay, so we've seen Garry Churchill and all the scams and the profiteering in the NHS and the psychology things that keeps the world in fear and trains all the world leaders so they can steal our continents. Okay? Far more crime has been committed by zealots in the name of God. Yeah. That's the Pilgrim Fathers and the FDRs and every great conflict and every great scam by the Masons and the women that are prepared to prostitute themselves and give up their body, like the woman at Princeton who drove Woodrow Wilson in, formerly in the Dad's Army team, now being replaced by a new version of Dad's Army. Yeah, it's absolutely massive. Everything I tell you, they have to cover up within a fortnight. And everything I tell you is on the front page of the papers. And I don't know how the border citizens, yeah, live with themselves. because those are the border citizens that are on the front page of the papers, and deny to me that their nickname Tutsi has anything to do with the religious fraud or the cover-ups, okay? Until I find out that the Watsons are implicated in the mafia linkages. Minor, minor roles, but they're still prepared to demean themselves and asset strip society and its decency. You should see the Tutsi website now, it will turn you blind. Karen, with the mental health expertise. Far more crime has been committed by zealots in the name of God than has ever been committed in the name of Satan. Okay, that's all the Piso stories about the young man that claimed that his great-grandfather, Arius Calpurnius Piso, was Satan in the Revelations chapter, and they want that out of the Bible now because it's so embarrassing for them. Okay, here's J. Edgar Hoover, the cross-dresser, was a 32-degree Mason, homosexual, and worked intimately with the Illuminati. That's J. Edgar Mary Hoover. Yet in the stories that Greg Hallett used to tell me on Skype before he got topped by HRH, who's really good at the occult. Right then. So we could go to full screen. No, let's keep it cozy. You should see the murders of the prostitutes and the actresses, and it's just everybody is tied into it, no matter how innocent you want to be. Actually, the comparison between the Mafia or the Cosa Nostra families and Moriah, that's again the Lord of the Rings joke, that's Moria. Yeah, that's the underworld where the elves and the dwarfs live, and that massive Balrog thing. Yet we had to go to Canterbury or Christchurch in New Zealand to buy the Balrog, and that's the thing that tries to interfere with the innocent people like Gwyneth Paltrow trying to save the world. Okay? That Satan has been running. Don't expect to find what you're reading here about the Collins family, that they are one of the very top Illuminati families, even more powerful than the Rothschilds. Yeah? I doubt that that is true. What we closed on yesterday was my website profiling how the Rothschilds are all over the crime scene for Prince Philip and all of those recent things involving the Dutch royals, and that is the Dutch royals and the Spanish royals that kill their own brothers and kill their rivals are in the Nazis, and they openly declare it in World War II, and they're still in power. I'm grateful for various ex-ringsiders giving me accounts of secret meetings. Before the 1960s and the space program, man had not seen the far side of the moon, but that didn't mean it wasn't there. Yeah, I don't believe that they've ever seen it. Yeah, and this is the story about the Collins family being on board. Yeah, consequently, some of the greatest philanthropists are leading Satanists. Yeah, that's all of the families that run all of the world. And we've not gotten to the Rothschilds yet. Who do you think of when you think of the Collinses? Joan Collins, she was beautiful, Jewish Hollywood actress from England. Joan's grandmother lived at Brighton, England. That's where the chair was for the sexual deviancy. England. Joan mentions her father being a Jew on page 13 of her autobiography. Her father, Joe, that's Brighton's secretaries and directors, where my wife was the scorers, and they're the massive launderers that her brother uses in the acid stripping of the dental students. Her father, Joe Collins, and his friend, Lord Lew Grade, that's the dad of Michael Grade, used to run the ITV companies and all of the things at the place where the Freemason with the fez on his head, Tommy Cooper, dropped down dead. That's the Palladium, the Paladin jokes about King Solomon. Had an acting company. Okay? So this is all of the massive Michael Grade business scams. Take in all of those dukes and duchesses all across our country, and even Hugh Fearnley Whittingstall, whom my wife loves on the telly. because all of the trivial people are covers in Phoenix Film Companies Limited 1 to 3, and all of them are on the boards of the Deutsche Bank, and all of them are covered by TV celebrities like I forget the name of the Deutsche Bank boss that has the cover in the Blue Peter team. Craven, John Craven at the BBC, is cover for the director at the Deutsche Bank, and that is just typical of how the money is spent on all of the cover-ups. Will Collins and his wife Can-Can dancer, yeah, everything's out of Paris for to demean how the whole world conducts itself, which is why, yeah, I did not have a stag night and I did not enjoy dancing to my wife that everybody loves someone sometime. Yeah, when your government asks you to do it to dismember your country, Valerie Jane Lees. Henrietta Collins were also into acting. In the 1970s she was in several horror movies and picked up the title Queen of the Horror Films, and Joan was nude in two sexy films, not her first, which were expected to do better at the box office than they did. Neither of the titles of these films bear repeating. Joan was the first old woman to be in the buff in Playboy, the December 83 Playboy. That's naked. There she is. That's the frontispiece. The centrefold in the Rupert Murdoch page 3 jokes. That's what the world thinks about now. I don't think if I get married again I will have a stag night. The issue is a collector's item. In her 40s she was still posing in the buff. Okay, let's get on to some serious stuff. Okay, here's some serious stuff. In 1982 Joan was asked to be the mistress of the ceremonies at Prince Albert's. Yeah, that's the bigamous Prince Albert for Victoria, who had his penis on a chain, and all of that is in the movie about the nymphomaniac that is the cover for all of my stories and the dead Greg Hallett stories. Yeah, and before the Queen and His Royal Highness Prince Philip, besides knowing that she is into astrology after looking at her autobiography, I don't pick up a hint of any religiousness. Okay, besides her amazing beauty, her lack of morals made her a perfect fit for Hollywood. Among her many friends, she had Sammy Davis Jr., the jazz man, Jane Mansfield, Satanists, and she rubbed shoulders with Henry Kissinger. Greg Hallett claimed that he was the world's biggest killer. Yeah, Winston closely behind him. San Moritz, yeah, and here's the Knights That Say Knee jokes and the links to the friends that are the drug runners all around the world. That's Aristotle Onassis on that tab. Okay, yeah, he's the friend of Churchill and pictured on the drug trading yachts in the Med, and that is the Philips light tube jokes. And then the Dutch Royals come in and that is the Philips electricity company. Edgar Bronfman, yeah, I keep saying the Bronfsteins, they're the bootleggers, and that's the film about the three brothers that are vicious, vicious people that run all of the, when they bring in, FDR brought in the imposition of a ban on alcohol drinking, and that is where in Scotland you had to go to the nearest parish because you could not drink in your own parish. Yeah, the whole thing is the beginning of the drug running and the narcotics. Okay, so this is the Bronfman family are the Jewish Illuminati that runs Canada, and they're on HRH's Privy Council. Still, okay, here's the Bromstein bootleggers and the pictures of them, they're really nice looking people. Bob Hoskins, eat your heart out. Okay, really nice looking people. Yeah, baseball bats in both hands so that they can get anybody that wants to stop them. Yeah, and that film about their brothers being so ruthless that they would cut people's throats. And if you were determined, like that man in the Flood film, who's George Clooney, to escape from it, what happened when the man's throat that was cut was by the bootleggers? You just hold it together and you keep breathing. Yeah, no charge for that. Okay, so that's the Bromsmans on the Privy Council, on the people that are in the Temple Bar that run all of the global law enforcement scams. There is no law enforcement, and the likeness to the Cockney is completely uncanny. Right then, so let's get down. Another picture. Joan was married several times, but obviously preferred her maiden name because it's a mafia logo. Okay, there's the one that's the Collins that went to the moon. Okay, Michael Collins was one of the three astronauts on the Apollo 11. Apollo 11 was the first officially announced visit by the man to the moon. For those who have read Be Wise as Serpents, you're aware that the first flag on the moon was the Scottish Freemasons' Rights flag. Yeah, Lord Sanderson about him in the syndicate with the Bourbons, yeah, and with Lady Jane Grosvenor. She's lucky she's a woman, she gets to fish with those icons. And there it is, the Scottish Rites Freemasonic flag flying on the fucking moon. And when they got out the spaceship, there were all sorts of footprints directly under it, because it had to be dragged there by the people that set the set up in Hollywood. That's totally irrelevant, okay? Yeah, and that happened when computers in Trevor Jones's lab, yeah, the billionaire Trevor Jones's lab, yeah, they were filling that lab at that time. Now you've got them inside your mobile phone. We've never been able to get back to the moon again, despite Edinburgh winning the Peace Prize, the Nobel Prize. When Iris reveal the SS in Edinburgh are still running the world like a mafia, and they run New Zealand, and David Murray is part of that. Buzz Aldrin, Bun Aldrin, is a Freemason too. Neil Armstrong has gone into seclusion, shunning any publicity. He still gets it from the man that is the head of the Scottish news mafias, who's Alistair Moffat, the head, former head, until they bring along the intel person, who's the Irish woman, who's now the head at Oxford. And all of it is a cover-up for all of the war crimes and all of the terror and all of the occultist leadership that our world is given. Illuminati's Rand Corporation. Here's the Tavistock Institute. My attempts to find it in London. It's in Tabernacle Street with the religious connections. Right then. So I could not find anything there other than the senior executives is Dr. Elliot Aron. Not Aryan, but very close. Dr. Elliot Aron, Chief Executive Officer. When you go to the American side, you get a completely different story. Thousands and thousands of registrations. Okay, let's get down to some more pictures. Michael Collins, for few men share his experience of seeing the tiny earth in the vastness of the hostile universe. And yet he doesn't. He simply advocates that humans learn to cooperate to solve our problems, which we certainly need to do. Michael Collins has some really interesting and, in a sense, inspiring things to say. We've got a Gillies van outside today on the mobile phone. Yeah, and that's the Gillieses that were when I was talking to them and their Labour Party colleagues. Yeah, that's the Gillies that was the Prime Minister in Australia. Yeah, in between 2010 and 2014. Now being replaced by a more traditional conservative. Okay? Right then. And yet he doesn't. So let's get to some pictures because we've not got much time, and see how far up the tab we are. Okay, the Collins family is an old New England family. That's Pilgrim Fathers. Yeah? Early members were Francis, Edward, and John. Part of the family is both related to aristocracy and to witchcraft. For instance, I have a complete list of all people accused of witchcraft in New England in the 17th century. Did you know that Mrs. Warboys in the Victor Meldew comedies was the last witch to be burned in England? The 17th century was the first century that British settlers, mostly Puritans, some of whom are also known as Pi Pi Piso pilgrims and Congregationalists settled in New England. In 1640, in Aquidae, Mass, a Collins was accused of witchcraft. In 1653, I think it's 1620 that the Mayflower sailed, Joan Collins was accused of witchcraft in Lynn, Massachusetts, and a Collins family lived in the Salem, Massachusetts area of Marblehead during the 1650s, when the witch trials occurred. Other people accused of witchcraft in early colonial Massachusetts include Young, Bailey, Carrington, Godfrey in Dad's Army, Hod Hall. We had a fire engine in my street yesterday. Hod Hall is a professional fireman. He used to be a friend of mine. He fishes for salmon on the TV, and we had the incident with the fire brigade yesterday, just as I was discovering that. Brown and Clinton, okay? I hope no one was injured. The ambulance service were there too. That's those that were invented in Geneva, strictly neutral in wartime. And all of the shenanigans about Hillsborough, which is the Queen's residence in sectarian Ireland. However, the worst example of dealing with witchcraft, the Salem witch trials, was instigated by the Collins family to destroy Christians. Okay, it's all about the money and the power. The Collins family brought witchcraft from England to America. For the first part of the 1700s, one of the British Collins was prominent in his books on deism against Christianity. Arthur Collins's 9-volume reference work, Valley Jane Lee's In the New World Authorship, Collins' Peerage of England, published in 1812, was a definitive work on aristocratic peerage. Obviously, Arthur Collins had a great deal of clout to be able to research such a massive work on people of significance in England. 9 volumes, okay? And all of the American pagans headed for their death in front of the Calvary Hill Cavalry. Those are the good guys against the witches, okay? John Collins, 1775 to 1820, born to a well-to-do Collins family, was in the tax haven as governor of Delaware. That's the Dilla Warrens, that is the rabbits joke. Yeah? Okay, the wealthiest Collinses that I have discovered so far is Matthew Garrett Collins, 1874 to 1925. He's an oil producer. And is named after Oliver Cromwell. Oliver Cromwell was the early Mason who was paid off by the Amsterdam Jews to allow the Jews back into England. Yeah, the whole thing is a coercion racket, and there are dozens and dozens of ruthless clans. And I got that message from the gods. And it's just amazing how brutal they're prepared to be. Collins manufactured silk like the Rothschilds, and in 10 years he took the operation in 1886, 2 years before we went to Khartoum, yet with the Christian nations, culling all the pagans and the slaves in Africa. From nothing to a $2 million business, that's 1886. Fuck knows what that's worth now. Should not swear, it's irreverent. He was president of Interstate Gasoline Company. He worked with several big other big oil men. Let's keep going to us so I can show you the pictures. This is the songs, all of it. Tulsa is a major headquarters for Satanism in that area. Okay, I'll click on that, see if it plays. Okay, that's Gene Pitney, 24 hours from Tulsa. That's a Satanist hub for the Collins family. Okay, everything is a joke in popular culture, which is why they're remaking Dad's Army really quickly. Okay, and we'll get the ad, and with any luck it could be the Dad's Army ad. I don't think Intel are foolish enough to do that. Oh, it is, I think it is. If playback doesn't begin, I think it's the Dad's Army ad.
shoulders back, son, to no guard on a sack of potatoes. It's all hands on deck. An enemy spy is operating somewhere here.
So, can you see how big it is? Dad's Army official trailer by Universal Pictures UK. Oh, it's a new film about it with a new cast, so that when you look up Butcher Jones, it will be a new actor. Nothing to do with the cartoon massacres or any other insightful person coming along and declaring that that is the FDR, Butcher Jones's park. Yet where the massive dams are, as the massive joke against the gods in the skies. And that's the fugitive film in the healthcare frauds. Oh. Let's watch it. That's the one.
The Home Guards become highly recommended.
You remind me of someone.
Winston Churchill.
I like to think that if we met, they'd both be the richer for it.
Oh, yeah.
Incense made in the Nazi dump.
I speak at a club.
One of my nannies was from Leipzig.
What's in my dear Zena, Manning?
What did you say, Godfrey?
Have you brushed your teeth, my dear?
So that's man wearing at the HSBC. Everything is a joke for profit. So, do you get it? Everything's a joke. That is, the Collins lost a number of the ships that they produced in their massive building programs for profit. Yeah, that is the Winston Churchill activity in wartime. He runs the Navy and the provisions for the Navy. Okay, lost a number of ships to natural sea disasters because that's the gods. And after the financial panic of 1857, the Collinses got out of shipping. And that is the deliberate crashes involving the Lloyds. Yeah, that's the Lloyds of the Isle of Skye. And their family came forward and talked to me yesterday, because this bit, this video also has a mention of the people that are the Cooper family that live in Nenthorne, right next to the military mansion that was part of the empire for one of the military leaders in World War II. Atwood Collins who graduated from Yale. That's the warmongering skull and bones institution. Yeah, Episcopalians, yeah, who are well-to-do Episcopalians, with the word piso in it. And those are the people that may be having the policy changes, because I keep seeing the people in the supermarket and they want to talk to me now. They're ever so aloof. Those are the people that have all of the Balfour names and the Scott names all around the church, and some of them are on the war memorials, and all of the piso inscriptions are on the rafters. Thank you for coming forward and talking and shaking hands and being civilised about it. Even the man from the Otterburn Hunt. It's the Mr. Dick jokes in Shakespeare's output. Not Shakespeare, Dickens. What the Dickens? Clifton W. Collins. Clifton studied St. Simon, who was the Mason Illuminatis that started communism in the Bible. Ooh, isn't that terrible? He was also involved with Bahrain Petroleum Company Limited during the 1950s. DeWitt Clinton Collins. Yeah, that's the wit to wit to woo. When you listen to the King's Speech final scenes, you hear him taking the piss out of that joke. And that is Bill Clinton, the half-brother of Queen Elizabeth II, by those Averill Harriman Churchills. Yeah, relatives of the ballistic Garry Churchill, the healthcare profiteer, and on the Tavistock mind control psychology team. His father, Clinton DeWitt, was also named after DeWitt Clinton. D.C. Collins did his postgraduate work in Vienna, where the Rothschilds' Five Arrows project is. Yeah, and that is Enid Blyton's famous five. Practiced in Chicago, where the Windy City jokes are. And I've just played Milton Friedman, the head of the IMF and the massive man that launched globalism out of the Windy City of Chicago. Hugh Collins, author and Marxist, and the law published by Oxford University Press. They're the Bible specialists owned by Robert Maxwell from Czechoslovakia. James Foster Collins worked for US intelligence for the United Nations.